Sport.
It's controlling me, it's the devil in me that likes winning, yeah. I'm round that corner, you see me coming. I'm on this thing like, yeah, with it.
They call me a killer, but I would just say I'm focused. Strong like a pillar, on top of you like a locust. Don't play around, I'm bound for bound. You heard me.
Well, hello from a city that truly loves its football, Marseille, the city in question, and our action comes to you from the Orange Vélodrome. I'm Derek Ray, joined here on the commentary box by Lee Dixon, and very much looking forward to bringing you live action from Ligue 1. It's Olympique Marseille up against Rennes.
Yeah, thanks as always, Derek. It's a pleasure to be here. Anticipating a really good game today. The atmosphere is great. Certainly buzzing from the spectators' point of view as we head towards kickoff. Hopefully, we won't be disappointed.
Hudson Edouard. Deary me, disappointing.
Well, as you know, I'm not a goal scorer, but I think I could have done better than that.
Well, as you can see, our hosts know a thing or two about scoring goals. In fact, Lee, they have the most potent attack in the league.
Yes, Derek, in front of goal, they seem to be faultless. Superb creative element to this team provides the chances, and they don't waste too many, do they? Clinical.
And room now out on the wing. Options in the middle. Throw-ins given. He's going forward well here. Wonderful tackle. Giving the ball to the opposition that time. He'll take this on. Well, that'll be a free kick. Well, Real Madrid have been very busy on the transfer front. They've assessed their target, Lee, and they've got him.
Well, Derek, a fee of around £95 million is what you've got to pay for quality these days. I think they're getting an absolute gem. I think he's worth double that.
Well, foul play, says the referee. Well, we can now go to Alan McInally for news of a goal elsewhere. Alan?
It's a goal for Paris Saint-Germain. 9 minutes played. 1-0.
Many thanks, Alan. Well, nearly shaving the crossbar with that powerful effort.
Well, that was the chance to take the lead, and the manager's frustration is there for all to see.
Well, showing good defensive judgment. Was a move of great promise. They could easily have been in. Well, that is annoying for any manager to see your own player giving the ball away from a throw-in. And space for the cross. Defensive efficiency personified. This might be ideal for the counter. Ruben Alcaraz. It's with Akhmetov. Can they trouble the opposition this time? Just knocking it around, looking to carve out a chance. Well, he just couldn't make it happen.
Très chers amis supporters, n'oubliez pas que plusieurs buvettes sont à votre disposition dans tout le stade. Merci.
The quality of pass needs to be a bit better. Hudson Edouard.
Well, possible.
And he's through here. Girassi. Kruse. Akhmetov. And Kruse. Can he put them in front? Well, good defending. Clattered out of there. Ruben Alcaraz. So a goal kick is what's coming up here. More action from Liga coming your way. It's Olympique Marseille, and they'll be taking on Racing Club de Lens.
Yeah, I'm predicting a cracker there. Both teams will have a real go at each other, I'm sure.
Weston McKennie. There to win it back. Good-looking ball. There could be a chance now. Oh, marvellous defending to deny him. It is to be a throw-in. Effective looking pass. How can they create something? Chance maybe. Excellent refereeing. Advantage in operation. And the referee sees that as a foul. Free kick given. And going short with it. Çalhanoğlu. Matteo Guendouzi. Oh, he's given it away. And a throw-in forthcoming. Weston McKennie. Odson Edouard. Luis Muriel. The cross is on. That's an effective cross aimed at the back post. Well, he had a decent reading of that ball in. And scope for them to produce. And a long way out. And that shot from seemingly miles out. Close.
Well, he got too much space and he thought, why not? Why not shoot from here?
Well, someone has found the net in one of the other games. Here's Alan McInerney to tell us more.
It's a second goal for Paris Saint-Germain. 31 minutes played. 2-0.
Thanks very much, as always, Alan. And space for the cross. Passing it around, looking for the goal that would put them ahead. Splendid tackle, and the outcome is a corner here. Played into the centre of the box. And a no-nonsense clearance. Dominik Heinz. Akhmetov. And room now out on the flank. Effective challenge. I believe there's been a goal in one of the other matches. Alan McInerney.
It's a goal for Auxerre. 35 minutes played. 2-1.
Regular updates from Alan McInerney along the way. And offside it had to be. Crystal clear.
Marseille possession stats are pretty good, but that doesn't lead to goals necessarily. They haven't created enough.
Can they forge ahead? They do! And you've got to say they're good value for the lead.
Obviously, it's a tapping, Derek, but it's the patience in the box I like. A predator's instinct, just waiting for the ball to come to him.
A chance to revisit the goal.
Well, the manager knows the importance of that goal. He also knows that you're at your most vulnerable just after you've scored.
The opening goal of the game then. This looks promising. Keeping possession of the ball with authority. Crisp tackling. And a throw-in it's going to be. Nuno Tavares. Matteo Guendouzi. And possession given away. On and on he goes. Çalhanoğlu. Terrific block there. Well, mopping up defensively. And the electronic board delivers the news. 2 minutes of stoppage time. Kruse. Jeremy Doku. An attack full of promise. Oh, he's lost possession. Can he finish? Can they slot it home? And so it is, the first half story has been written. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Kruse. Well, nothing productive, really. An alert intervention. Fruitful looking attack. Excellent challenge. And let's join Alan McInerney now, because I believe there's been a change to the scoreline in the Saint-Étienne game. Alan.
It's a second goal for Saint-Étienne.
Can he finish this? Well, he did his job defensively. And he knocked it over the touchline, so it will be a throw-in here. A chance to whip it in. That was perfectly timed, and it is going to be a corner. Played into the centre of the box. Serious miscue in terms of the strike. Easy for the keeper.
No, he won't have an easier shot to save today. That was really awful finishing from the attacker. Well, Derek, there you go. Just look at those stats. They've certainly got forward enough, but the finishing has been absolutely woeful. You wonder if they're going to live to regret that, and they should be out of sight by now.
More excitement from Ligue 1 coming your way on EA TV. It's Rennes facing Nantes.
Yeah, the fixtures come in thick and fast. Should be a good game, that. Though hopefully that's not the commentator's curse.
Delivered into the box. It was well stopped.
Well, the positioning is everything for a goalkeeper, and he was in a good position then.
Apologies to Alan McInerney for having to cut him off. For clarification, Saint-Étienne did score in that game, and their advantage at the moment stands at 2-0. Well, that's a really good authoritative tackle. Throw in here. Can they get in behind them? Strength and control, a big part of his game. Ruben Alcaraz.
Jeremy Doku.
And it's Max Kruse now. And here's the chance, Max Kruse! Absolutely spot on with that challenge. Well, the pass not finding its target. As clean as a whistle, that challenge. Half an hour remaining then. He's in with a chance. Oh, it might be. It's in. They're looking really relaxed and confident and not giving the opposition much of a look in.
Well, here it is again, and it's all about the pace in transition. They were so quick to get out from the back, and when he gets through to the keeper, he just smashes it past him and gives him no chance to think. A lovely finish.
So, 2-0 now. Girassi. Kruse. On to Alcaraz. Well, that is how to play advantage. Akhmetov. Keeping the ball moving. And Kruse. A chance to eat into their lead. And up for grabs off the keeper. Well, he did his job defensively. So a throw in here. Dominic Heinz. Jeremy Doku. It's with Akhmetov. In a position from which they could potentially do a bit of damage here. That's a very impressive piece of defending. This might be ideal for the counter. And winning it back. Muriel. And teammates to play it to. That ball was put into the right area, but no one able to capitalize. Ruben Alcaraz. Well, they couldn't keep possession. Marseille couldn't maintain possession. Good pass. Promising looking attack. Good looking move this. A chance for them to provide a test in the form of a corner. Well, they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. And over comes the corner. Well, they had a decent reading of that ball in. And the counter-attack is on. Options available. Inside the last quarter of an hour. Couldn't hang on to the ball. Over the touchline for a throw-in. And options in the centre. Real danger. Looks promising this. Untidy in possession. Matteo Guendouzi. Careless in possession. Piontek. Well, what can they do to stop him running at them? Very much run of the mill as saves go. Muriel. That was simply miles off target. Dear me.
Oh, close your eyes when you're watching this one. It's horrific.
Le numéro 9, Serou Guirassy. Son remplaçant, le numéro 39, Irvine Cardona.
Oh, good defending to stop a decent looking attack. Dominic Heinz. Mauwasa with it. And plenty of room in the wide area. Well, it could be on for him here. Well, it was never going to worry the keeper.
Well, no wonder he's looking a little bit sheepishly at his teammates. Head in a hand sort of moment.
Making excellent progress with the ball at his feet. Piontek. Matteo Guendouzi. Well, no way through. It might be perfectly set up for the counter-attack, you know. Goalkeeper should take charge. What about the stoppage time situation? 2 minutes the word. Kruse. It's with Akhmetov. It's opening up for them. Deciding to go inside. And he's clear his lines. And there it is, the final whistle. And it's a victory for the home side. They're going to be happy with this result, Lee.
Well, Derek, as we said, this team love a goal fest. And they certainly know where the target is. Lovely, lively build-up and a real sharp cutting edge to this lot. Great entertainment, really enjoyable.
Shaving the crossbar with that powerful effort. And scope for them to produce, and a long way out. And that shot from seemingly miles out, close.
Well, he got too much space and he thought, why not? Why not shoot?
Can they forge ahead? And you've got to say, they're good value for the lead. He's in with a chance. Oh, it might be. It's in. They're looking really relaxed and confident and not giving the opposition much of a look in. That was simply miles off target, dear me.
Oh, close your eyes when you're watching this one. It's horrific.
Well, it could be on for him here. Well, it was never going to... Can they forge ahead? And you've got to say, they're good value for the lead. He's in with a chance. Oh, it might be. It's in. They're looking really relaxed and confident and not giving the opposition much of a look in.
Je suis avec l'entraîneur qui accepte gentiment de répondre à nos questions. Merci beaucoup pour votre disponibilité.